let this be a normal field trip?
With the friends? No way!
Cruising on that main street, you're relaxed and feeling good.
Yeah.
Next thing that you know, you're seeing.
Yeah.
What's in my neighborhood? Surfing on the sound wave, swinging through the stars.
Yeah.
Take a nap at your intestine. Take your second life at Mars.
I'm a magic school bus.
Navigating
nostrils.
It's a wild ride.
Come on, ride on the magic school bus.
Kids, get inside the bus. There's a new pair of mass murderers on the loose in Worcester. They're nicknamed the Artie and Nick Killers. Don't leave your drink unattended on the playground. These two masterminds are killing people by spiking their drinks with arsenic.
Ah!
We're all gonna die!
Drama queen.
Take a deep breath, class. Arsenic is a chemical that disrupts the normal function of the cell, specifically the metabolic pathway and the reaction.
Well, maybe if I knew that, I wouldn't be so freaked out.
That's a wonderful idea, Wanda.
Teacher's pet.
Today we are going to venture inside the cell. Let's take a closer look. As well as our destination, the mitochondria.
Wow! Did you see those molecules break apart the carbon ring into three carbon chains?
There go some other molecules whizzing by! They must have a lot of energy in them. Looks like there's 1, 2, 3, 4 ATP and 1, 2 NADH pluses.
Very good, Wanda. We're going to follow those three carbon chains, Ralphie. Time to go see the energy powerhouse of the cell. Off to the mitochondria.
What happens now, Miss Frizzle?
We die!
Not quite. The next step is carbon dioxide breaking off a molecule, which causes NAD plus to turn into NADH plus, allowing coenzyme A to attach the old pyruvate molecule, making acetyl-CoA. The enzyme that helps this process along is called pyruvate dehydrogenase.
Well, that doesn't seem hard.
Speak for yourself.
Oh no, we aren't done yet. We still have to go through the Krebs cycle.
What does that do?
That process produces more carbon dioxide and provides energy to activated carriers, which will go on to create ATP and power the cell. But let's stop here for a minute. This is a great place to introduce arsenic, a deadly poison.
That seems scary.
Well, it works right here in the mitochondria, right at this very step. Arsenic is an allosteric inhibitor of the enzyme complex pyruvate dehydrogenase.
Okay?
Hang on, I'll keep explaining. This means that arsenic stops pyruvate dehaze, which, I said earlier, converts pyruvate to acetyl-CoA.
Oh, right, I was paying attention.
Okay, so remember when I said we still had to go through the Krebs cycle?
Yeah, I remember.
You can't go through the Krebs cycle without acetyl-CoA.
Uh-oh, that seems bad.
You are exactly right. It is bad. This not only means no Krebs cycle, it also means no electron transport, and then glycolysis cannot happen.
Those are all the main ways a cell can power itself, right?
Yes, they are. The cell still has two other ways of making emergency energy in a situation like this, though.
What are they? Can it keep a person alive?
Are we gonna die?
They can keep you alive for a little while, but I'm afraid they cannot save you. The cells can either burn fat or go through fermentation. Burning fats allows you to create acetyl-CoA, so you can go through the Krebs cycle to get energy. However, once your fat reserves run low, this is no longer a viable option.
This is a great excuse for Mom to let me have 2 desserts.
Finally, some good news!
Your cells can also undergo lactic acid fermentation. This process can also give you energy, but not very much and for not very long.
So basically, arsenic makes you a goner.
And there goes the good news.
Yes, if you continue to ingest it, it will eventually affect your metabolism, burn all of your fat reserves, and leave your body without energy.
Well, now that we know all of this, how are we going to stop these bad guys?
Let's leave that to the professionals.